a pure blue flame where the hawks go. After the snows on the next warm day, there were the solo hikes in the mountains along the game trails, with a lunch of roasted chilies and meats and bottles of beer stuffed into a satchel slung over the shoulder. Where the trails go up on the sides of the mountains, the snow melts down and runs like a clear brook. And if you pause to bend an ear to it, you can hear the water going over the rocks and falling onto itself. It's wet and sloppy in the valleys, but the low parts are where the sun doesn't come, so it's cooler, and the air feels heavier because of the smell of the earth and the oak. But up high along the ridge, there is a pond where it's hot in the afternoon and nice to lay about without a shirt and feel the wind across your chest like it was summer. There are fresh tracks everywhere at the water's brink, and you'd even think you heard fish jumping, but it would only be snow dripping from the young pines bowed over the edge of the pool. In time, everything would get lazy, hot, sleepy, and after eating and sketching and writing, then laying down on your back in the grass after drinking all the snow-capped bottles of beer, sleep would come, and from way off, a shrill whistle note, and maybe you dreamt it and maybe you didn't, but it was there in your head, and out over the high pines you'd feel something soaring, and opening your eyes to look up through the pines, you'd know the sky was a pure blue flame where the hawks go.